This video is for the second part of the logs I section of the logarithms module. In this video we're looking at exponential growth and decay functions. And the general form of an exponential growth and decay function is a equals initial a or a sub 0 e to the plus or minus kt. Okay, so for exponential growth, a equals initial a or a sub 0 e to the positive kt, so growth means you have a positive constant, a positive k. Exponential decay, a equals a sub 0 initial a e to the negative kt. So what you're looking at here is when we're looking at growth, we're looking at a positive constant. When we're looking at decay, we're looking at a negative for that growth constant. Okay, so let's look at some examples. The first one here, the price of a bag of lollies in 1981 was 20 cents. The cost of lolly bag C in dollars is described by the exponential equation. And we have the exponential equation, okay, where T is the years since 1981. What was the cost of a bag of lollies in 1991? Okay, well, it says here that T is the number of years since 1981. So if we're looking at 1991, our T would be 1991 minus 1981, which is 10. Okay, our C equals 0.2 e to the 0.08 T, and we just plug that 10 in for our T. So that equals 0.2 e to the 0.8. And then when we plug that in our calculator, we get approximately 0.5. It's a worded question, it's an application problem, so we always finish with a worded answer. So therefore, in 1991, a bag of lollies cost approximately 45 cents. Okay, next one, in what year would it be expected that a lolly bag would cost $1? So here we don't know what T is, but they tell us that C is 1. Okay, knowing that our cost, which is given in our question, is in dollars. Okay, so again, write our formula. Plug in what we have, so 1 equals 0.2 e to the 0.08 t. Now we need to get that t on its own, so the first thing we need to get rid of is that 0.2, so we just divide both sides by 0.2. Now 1 divided by 0.2 is 5, so we have 5 equals e to the 0.08 t. Now what we want is that t up there, and t is a part of an exponential, so if we rearrange this in the form of a log, and it's going to be a natural log because we have an e here, so we've got ln of 5 equals 0.08 t. Okay, from there we need t on its own, so we divide both sides by 0.08. So now we have ln of 5 over 0.08 equals t. Plug that in your calculator and you get 20.1 is approximately t. Okay, so from there you would have to go, therefore, the price of a lolly bag, oh, and again, wait a second, this is t in years from 1981, isn't it? So it's 20.1 years, so we're going into the 21st year, so 1981 plus 21 equals 2002. So therefore, price would reach $1 in the year 2002. Okay, now imagine that most people have the biggest problem with this step here. Okay, so from getting to here, just remember that you're just rearranging from an exponential into a log. Okay, so that's all we're doing there. And how we're doing that is we're using that rule, if a to the n equals x, then log a of x equals n. Okay, so that's all we're doing. We're just rearranging it. Another question. The population of Queensland was approximately 2.35 million in 1981. Okay, and 3.64 million in 2001. Assuming the population of Queensland is growing exponentially, predict what the population of Queensland will be in 2010. Okay, so we're looking at exponential growth here. So our formula is normally A equals A sub 0 or initial A, E to the KT. In this case, because we're talking about population, let's make that A P. Now let's look at our information. It says P0 will be our initial population. So let P0 equal initial population. And in this case that's 2.35 million. Okay, we have, because we have no equation, we have to define our variables. We'll let T equal number of years since 1981. Okay, so this defining variables is very important when you're not given the variables in the equation. Okay, so now we have that P0 is 2.35. Okay, we also know that P, which is our final population, is 3.64. And we know that T is going to be 2001 minus 1981, which is 20. So we come back to our formula and we plug all this information in. So we have 3.64 equals 2.35 e to the 20k. From there we have to divide both sides by that 2.35, so we have 3.64 over 2.35 equals e to the 20k. We need to get that k on its own, so we're going to rearrange into a log, and it's going to be a natural log because of that e there. So ln of 3.64 over 2.35 has to equal 20k. From there, to get k on its own, we need to divide both sides by 20. So ln 3.64 over 2.35 all over 20 equals k. Note, I haven't evaluated things along the way. I don't want to keep approximating. I'm going to plug all of this last bit into the calculator and get a more accurate answer. When I do plug that in the calculator, I get 0.0219 is approximately k. We have to finish with a therefore statement. Oh, sorry, no, we haven't finished yet. We only found k, haven't we? So from there, plug that back into our original formula. P equals P0 e to the 0.0219 t. Now note, when I use this formula, I'm still going to use that point, that actual answer here for this k from my calculator, so I'm not approximating, so I'm going to use the answer button on my calculator. Okay, so now what does the question ask? Predict what the population will be in 2010. Okay, so 2010 means that T is going to be 2010 minus 1981, which is 29. Okay, my initial population is still that 2.35. So I've got equals 2.35 e to the 0.0219 times 29. Plug that into the calculator and you get approximately 4.43. So therefore, population of Queensland in 2010 will be approximately 4.43 million people. Okay, one thing to note, although I have gone across like this because I couldn't fit it on my page, you wouldn't do that. You would work down the page. Don't work across. Okay, another example. The sales of laptop computers each year has been increasing exponentially. For a particular country, the number in thousands of laptops sold is given by n equals 6.4 bracket 4 bracket to the power of 3.3t. Note that bracket there isn't really necessary. It's just showing, keeping it separate, but it's not necessary. Okay, T is the number of years after 1990. Okay, so our variables have actually been defined here, so we don't have to worry about defining them ourselves. And it's telling us that N is the number in thousands, okay, of laptops. Question is, in what year will the number of laptops exceed 1 million computers? Okay, now again, we're looking at exponential growth. Now, N is number in thousands. So in this case, it's telling us 1 million computers, but we want to work out what that is in thousands. So 1 million, which is 1 with 6 zeros on it, to work out what that would be in thousands, you would simply divide by 1,000. Okay, and you can just think about the zeros cancelling. Don't have to really go to your calculator. So it's 1,000. So it's 1,000 thousands, if that makes sense. Okay, so that means our N is 1,000. Okay, I'm going to move that over to here so I have more room. N equals 6.4 times 4 to the 0.3 t. Note, I've just used a little dot here. Dot down the bottom means multiply in mathematics. So that's something new. Your other option is just to keep it in brackets. Okay, so let's plug in. We have 1,000 equals 6.4 times 4 to the 0.3 t. First thing I'm going to get rid of is this 6.4, so I'm going to divide both sides by that. And that leaves me with 4 to the 0.3 t on the other side. Now, my base here is a log 4, so when I rearrange it, I have a log to the base 4 of 1,000 over 6.4 equals 0.3 t. I now have to divide by that 0.3, so log 4 1,000 over 6.4 all over 0.3 equals t. Okay, now to evaluate that log, what you're going to have to do, and I'm going to divide my page like this, so on the left hand side I've just got extra working. If I wanted to do that log 4 of 1,000 over 6.4, that's just going to be log of 1,000 over 6.4 all over log of 4. Okay, and then that's what you're going to be using in that. So if I plug that into my calculator, which I'm going to do now, I have log bracket 1,000 divided by 6.4, close my bracket. I would then press an equal sign, divide that by log of 4, and we get approximately 3.644. But when I come over here, I'm going to actually use that answer that I just have on my calculator. I'm just going to divide it by 0.3. Okay, so I've got T is approximately 12.1. Okay, so now we're looking at time, and N was number of years after 1990. Okay, we're over 12 years, so we're under our 13 year. So 1990 plus 13 equals 2003. You would then finish with a therefore statement, which I can't fit. It'd be something like, therefore, sales of laptop computers would be expected to have exceeded 1 million in the year 2003. Okay, always remember that therefore statement. Next, at a constant temperature, the atmospheric pressure of P decreases with the altitude H above the Earth's surface. Again, our variables are defined. So atmospheric pressure is P and altitude is H. For altitudes up to 10 kilometres, the pressure P in millimetres of mercury is approximately given by. So that's my formula, where H is in kilometres. Find the atmospheric pressure at an altitude of 6.2 kilometres. Now note, I don't really need to be too stressed about all the information in the question. If I write down the formula, now it told me that H is altitude, so H is 6.2. So I just plug it in, 760 e to the negative 0.125 times 6.2. Just while I'm there, note that we have a negative there, and that's because We're decreasing, it's decay. Okay, plug this into my calculator and I get approximately 350. So therefore, at 6.2 kilometers, the atmospheric pressure is approximately 350 millimeters of mercury. Now, I knew that it was millimeters because that was given up there. Okay, next, at what altitude will the pressure be 300 millimeters of mercury? So in this case, I'm going to write my formula. Now, what they've done here, they've told us what P is this time. So P is 300 millimeters. So plug that in. And now we're going to rearrange. So you can kind of see we've got two types of questions here. One where we're just simply plugging in and one where we're solving for the unknown. Okay. I'm not going to simplify, well, I can simplify that a little bit without, I can just take the zeros off there. But I'm not going to be too worried about it. Like you don't, I personally wouldn't bother about simplifying that. I would just leave it as 300 over 760 because it saves you time. You don't have to worry. When I rearrange that, it's an exponential, so log, natural log, 300 over 760 equals negative 0.125H. And then we have to divide by that negative 0.125. So ln 300 over 760 all over negative 0.125 equals H. Plug that into the calculator and you get H is approximately 7.5. Kane, I don't have enough room to put my therefore statement, but you can see one in the textbook. It's just the atmospheric pressure would be 300 millimeters of mercury at an altitude of approximately 7.4 kilometers. Note that I put that approximately in my answer. Last thing we're looking at is half-life. Now, for radioactive decay, the half-life of a substance is a time taken to reduce the amount to half of the original amount. Kind of makes sense. So how long does it take to get to half? The half-life H for a radioactive substance can be defined as H equals natural log of 2 all over K. Okay. In some cases, it may be necessary to determine the decay constant or use a half-life to solve problems. So let's look at an example of that. The element radon 222 is a radioactive substance with a half-life of approximately 3.8 days. If a scientist buys 150 grams of radon, how much will remain radioactive in 20 days? Okay, now there's two ways of looking at this question. First one, I can just use that H equals natural log of 2 over K, and I know H is 3.8 days. That's the half-life. Okay, so I've got 3.8 equals ln of 2 over K. So rearranging, K is going to be ln of 2 over 3.8, which is approximately 0.182. Okay, from there, my formula is exponential decay because it's decreasing. And I know my initial amount was 150. Okay, and I know that T is 20. So I just plug that in. 150 E, K is negative 0.182 times by 20. Plug that in the calculator and you get approximately 3.94. Okay, so after 20 days, approximately 3.94 grams of radon will remain radioactive. Okay, another way of getting that K, if you're not going to use that formula, if you don't want to cloud your brain with yet another formula, is start with your exponential decay formula. Okay, now in this, you know that A, your final amount, is going to be your initial amount divided by 2. You're going to have a half left. So here we can just go initial a over 2 equals initial a e to the negative k times, now t is still 3.8. Okay, because it's 3.8 days. So we can put 3.8 here. Okay, these here cancel, dividing both sides by a sub 0. So now we have a half equals e to the negative 3.8 k. Rearrange into a log. Natural log of a half equals negative 3.8 k. Divide both sides by negative 3.8 k equals natural log of a half divided by negative 3.8, and you get approximately 0.182. So you can see that that matches. Okay, so there's two different ways of finding k. Again, you would still then go from this part into there. Why would you do it this way? Well, you're not having to remember a number formula. It's sometimes a good thing. So what can you do now? Well, you need to practice those kind of application problems for exponential growth and decay. And you can find those exercises under logs I3 in your textbook. When you've done that, you've actually finished the module. So you need to start revising. There's a summary module or a summary section in your book under logs J. So have a read of that, make sure you understand it. There's also a review exercise that you can complete. Now when you do that review exercise, if you hit a question and you think, oh, I have no idea how to do that, then you need to go back to that section of your textbook, or even go back and watch that video that matches that section. Okay, and you've also got your sample module test to do. Okay, you should do all of those things before completing the actual module test and submitting, because that will save you time in the long run. Good luck. And congratulations for finishing logs, I should say.